everyone, and welcome back to SF Drew Reviews, and if you're new, welcome. I'm Supreme Girl, and this is my YouTube channel, where once a week I review some sort of toy. And so today I'm reviewing this Polly Pocket, little compact, I guess you could call it. So if you guys don't know, Polly Pocket actually released in like 1990 or something like that, 1970s, 1980s, I don't remember the exact year, but they've been out for a long time. However, in, I believe, 2015, they were discontinued, but now in 2018/2019, they have returned to shelves with both the little compacts and like the bigger dolls. And so I actually have a bunch of the bigger dolls, but I only have one of the vintage compact sets. So I'm really excited to see what this one looks like, just because I have an idea of both the bigger dolls and the little compacts that they used to sell. So I have like from each decade of like Polly Pockets that I had, since they really re-released them many times and changed them up a lot. So yeah, let's get started. So first of all, let's take a closer look at the packaging. So we see Polly right here, and it says Polly Pocket, and she's holding a little locket. And this set is recommended for the ages 4 and up, probably because of all the small pieces that you get inside. And if we look here, it seems like the compact folds into a little like keychain that you can put on your backpack or something. And if we look at the back, we can see that we can go to Polly Pocket or play.pollypocket.com to check out cool videos. And here we see a picture of the compact with Polly inside of it. So now, let's open this up. Okay, so here we have everything laid out on the table. And so first off, before we take a look at any of the items, I thought I would mention that on the packaging, it actually says that the dolls really stick. So I'm interested to test out this poly stick surface that they have going on. So we're going to try that in a moment. But first, let's take a look at all the items that we get. So first of all, we get the actual compact, which has this little like TV, which seems to be able to fold down so we can look at like a different show or something. So yeah, that's that. And then it's got little like bookshelves, and none of these open though. But, you know, it's really tiny, so. And then we have the poly stick surface, which doesn't feel sticky, so I'm interested to find out that. And I think this is, yes. Okay, so this is the little, like, couch, and it folds out into a bed. So I think that's really cool that this is basically her entire home, if we can call it that. Then the compact, yeah, I guess the compact actually does stand up and, like, keep this in place, so I feel like it's not like super stiff compared to the old compacts. So yeah, that's that. Then we get this little ring, which isn't super high quality, but you know, I think it's okay. And that I think we're supposed to put on in the back right here, so we can put it on our little like backpack or keys or something. We get this really tiny pizza box, which actually has a pizza inside of it, and I believe we can fold it to close it. Yes, so this is what it looks like closed. And I believe this is probably gonna break after a while if you like keep continually opening and closing it. So we're just gonna keep it closed for now, as I anyways just chipped my nail with trying to open it. So we're just gonna place that right there. Then we even get this tiny little coffee table, which seems to have like a game on it, but the game isn't really like colored in, so it's hard to tell if it's just like bunch of things sticking out of the table or an actual game. And again, these are so tiny, so it's hard to tell, but if you focus the camera, you can kind of see what I mean with a game on the table. So we can put coffee table in here, so it doesn't really actually fit that well. The place is so tiny that these accessories don't really fit inside of there. We even get a little teddy bear, which is this pink one, and it's really adorable and really really teeny tiny. So you could easily lose these little accessories. And I actually can't remember any of these little like accessories from the vintage Polly Pocket dolls, just like bigger accessories like cars and stuff. And then here we have the actual doll. And so she's kind of weird. She's like this like really like squishy and stretchy, but her arms aren't. Like some parts of her, like her hair and her legs, are completely squishy and like stretchy, but like her arms and her face are like really stiff. And also like her torso. So yeah, that's really weird. And her legs are kind of like sticky, so I get that's where the poly stick surface comes from. And also her hair is kind of sticky. And I get this feeling that this is material that will easily get like cat hair and like dog hair and like your hair on it, because I'm already noticing now that dust has like collected on the doll, which is not so fun. And again, I feel like it's a little weird that her legs are really like flimsy, and she doesn't really like bend to like sit, because again her torso is really hard. While with the old vintage Polly Pocket mini compacts, they could actually sit, like they had a little joint at their hips, sort of speaking. So yeah, that's one thing to take into consideration. So now let's try the whole poly stick surface. And here's why, again, why I was talking about the compact really easily opens up. And so, oh wow, it actually does stick. Okay, so now Polly's in place, and we're gonna do the upside down test. And she does not fall out of there. So that's actually really, really cool, because you won't lose Polly, at least, if she's sitting in there. The only thing is that accessories do not have any poly stick surface on them, so you're gonna lose those. But at least you have the most important part, or I think the most important part, which is the doll, which is not coming out on there. But let's see how hard it is to take her off. Oh, it is hard. See that? I have to like pull her off. I have to like peel her off. Okay, so the good thing is she doesn't like fall off. If I place her there, she will stay there. Like, even if I shake this and like put it upside down, she will not fall off. The bad news is you have to really like pull. Okay, that time went a little smoother. But the first time, as you saw, like her legs were literally stretching. So yeah, that's Polly. I think it's really neat that she is even standing on my desk without. Oh, I was about to say without falling over. And what do you know? She falls over. So I think that's really cool. Let's see if everything fits inside of here. Oh, and here's the bed. So let's see. Bed is kind of small for Polly, but you know, it works for one person. Now let's test if we can squeeze everything inside of here. So we're gonna place the pizza in here, the little coffee table, the teddy bear, and Polly. And we're gonna see if we can close it up or not. No, we cannot. Wonder if we're gonna need some serious organizing, I cannot get her inside of here. Well, that's a disappointment if she doesn't actually fit in here. Because I think the coffee table and the pizza and stuff fits. Pizza's in fact getting stuck underneath the bed, which is not a good sign, because that means the pizza will go bad underneath there. Okay, so we have the teddy bear, coffee table, and the pizza. But now, how do we get Polly to stay in here? I cannot get Polly inside of there. So that's kind of a disappointment. If you guys have this set, let me know in the comment section down below if you were able to squeeze everything inside of it, because I cannot get all the items inside of there. I can't get Polly in there specifically. And then this ring doesn't want to open. Okay, for a second I thought the ring didn't work either, but it does. Okay, so here's the ring. So the ring goes on, and you can put this on your backpack. My only complaint is that I could not squeeze in all items inside of there. Well, all the items, but not the actual doll, because her arms are like stiff and hard. I can't like squeeze them, and so even just placing the doll in there was really tricky. So, other than my few little complaints, I would say this is a really, really cute set. Like, I think the doll herself, if we ignore the fact that her arms are really hard, but then again, the old ones were too, and that her legs were really like sticky and squishy and like stretchy. I think the actual doll is like really cute and has a lot of detail to her compared to the old dolls, which is no surprise since printing technologies and stuff have been getting way better. And the compact is again okay when it comes to like keeping it open. I mean, I can't have it like this open, but it falls like down easily. And my complaint is that I can't fit all the accessories inside, or like all the accessories and the doll inside. But if you can, let me know and I'll maybe try it again and post it to my Instagram. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed it, this video that is, be sure to give it a huge thumbs up. Click that red subscribe button if you haven't done so already. Also, check out the informational links down below, such as to my Patreon page, my website, my blog, and my other YouTube channels. Until next time, bye!